Hi, I'm Jim Covington. On behalf of the Illinois State Bar Association, I'd like to welcome you to this week's issue of ISBA Statehouse Review. Today's date is January 31st, 2013. I have six bills I'd like to briefly discuss with you. These are bills will all have been recently introduced. They're all what I would call family law bills. The first one is House Bill 1004. It's introduced by Representative Bob Pritchard from DeKalb, and it amends the Marriage and Dissolution of Marriage Act to allow a party to request and a court to grant temporary relief that would include requiring a party to surrender to the court or the petitioner's attorney any passport or foreign passport issued to the child, and some other things along that. Obviously, that's constituent driven, as most of our family law legislation that is introduced is, and that's just been introduced. The second bill is a rerun from last year. It is House Bill 1018, introduced by Representative Mike Zaliski of Chicago, and it authorizes a trial court to order the parties and the minor children to participate in, quote, integrative family therapy, close quote, in a dissolution proceeding or post-judgment proceeding involving children. And apparently the trigger for the judge to do this is the presence of substantial and ongoing conflict about custody or visitation, putting the children at risk to develop pathological conditions or depression and these kinds of things. The third bill is also by Representative Mike Zaliski from Chicago, and that is affecting false allegations of child abuse or neglect that are made during the course of a custody or visitation proceeding, and that's House Bill 1019, and it allows the judge to refer it to the local law enforcement or the Department of Children and Family Services if the report is false or unfounded. If I understand it correctly, then it gives the court requires the court to hold a hearing on it to determine if there's any sanctions or not. The fourth bill is House Bill 1041, introduced by Representative Mike Tryon of Crystal Lake. And under the current law, a payor, the employer, can deduct up to $5 a month for doing an income withholding for child support. It deletes that current statutory authority to take no more than a $5 fee. The next bill is Senate Bill 1169, introduced by Senator Pat McGuire of Joliet. And in the current income withholding notice statute, it must include the date that the withholding for current support terminates. This bill just simply goes in and deletes the requirement that that date be put in the notice. The sixth and final bill is, and it creates the Uniform Collaborative Law Act, and it's House Bill 1029, introduced by Representative Robin Gable from Evanston. It is identical to Senate Bill 31, introduced by Mike Nolan of Elgin, and it creates the Uniform Collaborative Law Act for family law cases only. That is a form of alternate dispute resolution. It's modeled after the Uniform Act that the Uniform Law Commissioners have provided, and you can check the website of the Uniform Law Commission to get short summaries or longer summaries of what the Act does. And we will see you next week. Thank you.